Let's go YouTube lovers! Today's rule is so simple. If you think you get smarter by watching today's video, smash the like button. If not, put the nasty gram in the comment section below. Better yet, you could give me any advice on how I can be better for you, okay? Anything is just fine with me. Oh, come on! Yeah, how many episodes have I done for you? Jesus, I've been only making 83 videos so far. I was planning ahead like how many videos I gotta keep making every single month, but I'm totally behind. I'm blind now. For the past couple of weeks, I had to engage in my duty at the farm. Like the whole day, I had to stay awake in a small room, keep watching the 13-inch display, talking with the global IT engineers via Skype. I was so worn out. No, I'm so tired. Now, you know, like I said before, I'm from tech industry, right? Yeah, and my job is to accurately test, identify, repair, resolve, document those technical issues with PC. And I have to also be familiar with hardware troubleshooting as well. Last week, I had a critical issue with wireless network at the farm, and I couldn't even have time working on YouTube at all. But even if so, my viewers on YouTube platform don't wait for me. You know why? Because they're gonna shift their favorite channel from mine to others. That's what I'm so afraid of. If you have compassion, warm heart, or long-term positive support for me, please keep subscribing to my channel. I'm so happy if you do that for me. Lately, I was feeling uneasy because I read a comment saying she's addicted to MDMA. Oh man, that's a bad joke. She's my idol, exactly my type. Such an attractive actress in an extravagant dress with a glamorous figure as Erika Sawajiri went to hell a week ago because of this. Dr. Mario, I don't feel well. Okay, breathing. Sharon, send in my next patient. She did the same sh**. Hell yeah, yeah, same idiomatic mistake. Yeah, you know how terrifying illegal drug would be in Japan as compared to America, right? Yeah, marijuana, cocaine, heroin, stimulated drug, every single one of them is illegal. And the police found her synthetic drug MDMA that's also called ecstasy. Yeah, they are all bad. No, so disappointing me. Yeah, she has been sponsored by many Japanese entertainment agencies, and she made millions of dollars every year. Plus, next year, she was supposed to play a main role in Japanese historical TV dramas, but she ruined everything. Yeah, because of this. In Japan, there are so many celebrities who got arrested by cops due to illegal substance abuse last year. Once you get too deep into those illegal drugs, of course you can't go away forever. Not only that, but also tobacco, alcohol, intensive sexual desire, gambling, video gaming, for example, they are all addicting you. Once you get hooked on it, you are toast. I know. You know that I'm right. Then why are people still doing the same sh**? I have listed the positive reasons why they started to get addicted. If you are eligible to even one of the following two selections, you better be careful. You need to feedback at least your past 5 years, and you go. You better go get the mental doctor ASAP. I'm telling you folks. The following two selections are basically from my personal preferences and perspectives. If you agree with me, please give it a like. If not, if you don't, then why don't you give it a like? I don't hope so, but anyway, yeah, better yet, leave me a comment if you have any further suggestions, alright? The rule is so simple. Let's go. Number one, big money. This is simple. If you are rich or you are from wealthy family, you may possibly have a chance to buy illegal drug. Like in the US, buying marijuana is super easy. Just get drunk at nightclub and hang out with strangers who look like pimps. And you negotiate in the back of the warehouse, and you can buy weed at not less than $8, for example. In Japan, the black market prices of marijuana is over 20 times as expensive as the same stuff in America. That's ridiculous, but it is the reality. That's why Japanese Yakuza doesn't stop selling weed. A few days ago, a small group of crime gangs was accused of cultivating 190 marijuana plants under the ground. Once they sell weed in exchange with cash, which eventually makes contaminated into a clean currency, they reinvest a growing app another weed so that they can make more dirtier money. That's also called negative compound interest. Well, I don't know too much about Yakuza world because I'm not involved with them, of course, but Yakuza family has a hierarchy structure which is similar to Italian mafia. From the top to the bottom of the layers, there is still a big organization in the Japanese gang world, although basically the entire Yakuza organizations has been gradually shrinking one after another year. Among with more than thousands of nationwide associates, senior executives who manage the black organization tend to be super smart. They can't be fooled, just like the same as you run the big company. Yeah, let's suppose that if you are at the farm working with your business associates, you can't be fooled, right? No, you can't act like a childish at the farm. Whatever you do, you can't make the wrong judgment to operate your business. If they know you are soft or inferior to them, they're gonna go away from you, and they take money from you and gone if the worst happens. That's why Yakuza always needed to be so smart and wise sometimes. You know, that's the same reason why Yakuza can't be gone forever. They know, you know, how to manipulate your mind control. They know how to get close to you if they know you are stupid rich. In terms of Yakuza, number two is a bit related. Number two, close friend. Look back at your surroundings with any kind of relationship, your classmate, your co-worker, or whoever you are always with. A little over a decade ago, my Japanese co-worker became friends with a Mexican customer when I was working at a rental DVD shop in LA downtown. Yeah, that was a long time ago. Neither of them had done so much together before, because at the time they were in B2C relationship. So, you know, my coworker was very open-minded, who could talk funny to anybody. I never doubt he must be a bad guy, and you know, they got something in common while they're talking each other together. It seemed that like they loved music. Yeah, they was in a good harmony with each other, and after they were off of work, so many of their first times ended up being together. I saw them doing something together, although I didn't get deep into it. Overall, it looked like it's been great fun, but over time I felt like their relationship had developed into an extended and meaningless experimentation with some kinds of mind-altering substance, namely marijuana. Before doing drugs, it was okay, but you know, they occasionally talked about the nightclub, girls, rap, hip-hop music, which inevitably cycles back to the more drug talk, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, it's sad. Yeah, it's very, very disappointing and depressing. That was one of the biggest heartbreaking occasions that I encountered a nice guy turning into bad guy. This may not be meant to sound harsh for you, because it's no real business and it's absolutely up to them to cultivate other aspects of their lives besides using drugs, but I don't know what to say. Yeah, once you encounter the problem, it's gonna be a symptom of a deeper problem. That's when drug is becoming the center of your life. It doesn't always mean you became addicted, but you know, I mean, perhaps your interest has been shifting from other hobby into this one. On the other hand, if you play soccer, it's normal to talk about soccer with your soccer buddy, your favorite teams, your favorite players, like how the last game you went on. And you know, why it should be any different if another hobby of yours is drug. Yeah, you talk about your favorite drug with your soccer buddy. like what's your favorite combination of drug? That's ridiculous, right? just check from time to time if you think you are being into something bad. Addiction is not always bad. You know, I was in the same position with playing basketball, and my mom told me I was so obsessed and addicted to no-paid basketball. It's not a good business for making money. That's what she thought. I didn't believe her, but in the end, I quit playing basketball, and to be honest, my life became a bit more fulfilled because I luckily found a side hobby, which is, guess what? YouTube. I didn't really like people who had only known for a short time and approaching me with one common interest because I was introvert. That's why I didn't have a motivation to take bad things further. If you are Japan, 99% of you okay with illegal drug abuse. You know, you never get to meet drug dealer or pimps for real. Don't worry about that if it doesn't matter to you. Now that you have realized this, all you gotta do is that you are gonna try and change things. Super easy, but super difficult. God blesses you. Once again, if you think you get smarter by watching today's video, hit the like button and ring the bell. Also, don't forget to subscribe to my channel as well. I appreciate your support if you could do so. Thank you so much for watching me on YouTube. That's all for today, and I'll see you in the next episode. See you later. Bye.